You dare to be an idiot in my presence? Take off your mask.
Sup, man?
Hey everybody, this is Kyle. This is my first how-to, hopefully one of many that I will make in the future. This one will focus on LEGOmation.
Now, LEGOmation, in a general term, is the manipulation or movement of Legos by stop-motion animation. So generally, this would be stop-motion animation. Of course, you could use a string on a really broken or loose Lego to move it around, but what's the fun in that?
Now, production takes a really, really, really long time. In the next bit, we will show you exactly how long that is with my own little commentary.
General setup for the scene. It can be very fun, but it can be very tedious if you don't know really what you're doing or where you're going to go with the scene. This scene you're seeing right now is actually fast-forwarded 1,500% faster than it normally would be. This camera recorded 20 minutes of footage of me setting up this scene. So we fast-forwarded it, of course, for your viewing pleasure. Where are you going? If you notice on your stop-motion animator, whatever you're using, it'll be surprising to you how much little progress it looks like you're making. Like, say you've been working for 15 minutes, it'll say you've only got 5 seconds or less footage. It's because frames don't necessarily measure in seconds, but it can be really annoying to like look back and say, hey, I got 15 seconds of footage done today. Whoopee. Back and forth. And I do think we're coming to an end of this footage, so I will see you in a couple seconds.
Oh, we're back on. That sequence you just saw, was a mere 10 seconds of actual footage for the stop motion animation. That says something, doesn't it? The next little bit you're gonna see is inspired by an actual Lego set that I lost years ago, and was actually a big franchise for Lego, but they kinda lost it. This is called Alpha Team, and it's about a kind of special ops group. Enjoy.
Sir, we have caught the prisoner. What do you wish for us to do with him?
Tie him up and then bring him to me for questioning. I wish to speak with him for a while.
Oh my god, a cliffhanger? How could he do that to you?
Well, that stinks. We're gonna talk a little more, and then we'll show you part 2. Now, most people generally have the question, how am I supposed to do this? Well, I'm here to answer most of those questions. Most of them. Not all of them, because some of your questions are really, really stupid. Now, your first question might be, why Legos? Legos are a very easy model to work with. Not like clay, where it's... I mean, sure, clay is a very customizable outlet of stop-motion animation, but Lego characters are very movable, and they're already very customizable. There's tons of little bits that you could use to make anything imaginable, and there's all kinds of characters. You got stormtroopers, you got terrorists, you got Boba Fett, aliens, anything possible.
Another question I get asked a lot is exactly how does stop-motion animation work?
Stop-motion animation works by taking a frame-by-frame snapshot of each individual tiny movement of whatever your manipulative outlet is, in my case, Legos. It's a very tedious process. You move each little... Like, say you're just animating a walking sequence. You move the leg, say, a centimeter to show it moving forward, and then you gotta switch the legs and the arms to give it the motion of movement, as you saw in the Darth Vader clip.
He walked down the hall, and that entire scene took about 2 days to make. It's a very long process. So, if you're thinking of going into stop-motion animation, be sure you have a lot of time on your hands.
Now, when you're doing stop-motion animation, you gotta find a good place to work. And a good kind of operating system to work. May I recommend a Mac? Because of Final Cut. And, frame by frame? It's a very good system. Unfortunately, it doesn't work on Windows, and Windows does not have very good stop-motion animation systems. They're often very expensive and or very, very bad.
A Mac in all of its beautiful, beautiful, beautiful glory. And it's Final Cut Express.
And now we're just going to move on to what I know you're looking forward to. Here's part two of Alf Team. Hope you enjoy it. Men, we are all here for the reason that we have an intruder, and we are here to execute him. Like we always do. Isn't that right? You just had to keep pressing your luck. Prepare to fire. Well, certainly looks like he's in trouble. We should go save him. I won't be able to pick you up for a little bit, but roger that. Off we go. We have an unidentified aircraft entering our airspace. This is not a drill. Repeat, this is not a drill. All officers to your stations. Once again, this is not a drill. Oh, well, that was unexpected. Everyone get your post. Yes, sir. I'll be back for you when I can. Alright, everybody, let's get to it. Hoorah.
Another cliffhanger? Well, that depends if I ever make another stop-motion animation film again. Maybe we will conclude our epic battle. Maybe. Oh, hey guys. These next bits were originally going to be a lot longer, but I thought they were just a little bit funnier, a little bit... They show a lot of different aspects that you could put into any stop-motion animation film. So enjoy the next little bits, and I will see you in a second.
Hey man, did you hear Kyle's making another stop-motion animation film? Ah, oh, he's an idiot. Hey guys, did you hear Kyle's making another stop-motion animation film? Yep, we all heard. Cool. You guys are idiots. He makes great films. He should make more. Does anybody wish to explain to me what that was? Hey, everybody. Oh, great, not you. Now, look, I know none of you liked my fourth movie, but come on. Cut me some slack, man. Please? No. Hi, I'm Colonel Sanders, and this is a KFC commercial. I have no KFC. Dang it. Hey, what? I hate you. Oh. Hey, guys, I'm the new guy. Go away. Hi, Colonel. I trust you are all enjoying the new help. Eh, you know, more or less. Oh, good, because you're all fine. What? Ah! Just think of this. Oh, hey, Bubba. Look, if you're going to be my apprentice, please stop laughing around. Watch this video. It'll help you become a good bounty hunter.
Thanks for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed this little presentation, and I hope you learned a lot. Now, if you have any more possible questions, you could always just ask me. I have a phone, and I'm in your class. So, you know. Peace, everybody, and happy animating. Ow!
He was just a rookie trooper, and he surely shook with pride. He checked all his equipment and made sure his pack was tight. He had to sit and listen to those awful engines roar. You